Hey everyone, Matt here. So I just wanted to quickly talk about frame sizes and our plans for this 2018 beekeeping season. So if you watch some of my videos from last season, you'll know at the very end we started the transition into a lay-ins frame size. And this is one of our conversion shims with the medium length trough on it. But this winter, I came across some interesting information. And it was put out by a feller named Greg V. And I seen it on the Treatment Free Beekeeping Forum. And he was also a guest on Solomon Parker's Treatment Free Beekeeping Podcast. And basically what he was saying was, if you're going to bother transitioning from your Langstroth size frames to a lay-ins frame, why wouldn't you build your hive bodies big enough so that you could transfer between the lay-ins and a Langstroth frame anytime? Because then for any reason, you could transition between lay-ins frames and Langstroth frames, whether they're mediums or deeps, at any time and for any reason, whether one reason would be, say you lost your bees and needed to buy some nukes, so you were going to get some deeps, and this is one of the deep conversion frames. And or say your neighbor, he needs some he's having some queen problems or brood problems, you can grab a frame of open comb, throw it into your hive, queen will lay it up, you give it to him, you know, just easy transitions between the two. And also then you could reuse your Langstroth equipment that you already have, like this. So Greg was saying he was going with the size, a Ukrainian frame size, which is actually, it's like 400 millimeters by 300 millimeters. But I decided that to give them just a little bit more space. So I'm actually going with a lay-ins frame size across the top and then just a Langstroth length down the bottom. And I actually made one of those frames. And so this is the frame one it's gonna look like, is that big for the new hives here. But and this one is just an idea that I got off the horizontalhives.com, where it's a foundationless one, so it's got a comb guide at the top, and then it's got another little dowel in the middle to support the wax. And then also, if you go to harvest this, then you can just cut out the top here, because usually the honey, like if you see this one, usually the honey is in the top section and then there's a bunch of brood at the bottom. So you could, you know, technically cut the honey out and leave the brood section there. So yeah, this year I'll be transferring fully to this size of a brood frame that we're going to use. And then also I got this one, I cut some slats in the top there. I'm going to make it kind of like a colmena lay-ins, which is like the Spanish style hive, where you stack supers on top and then the bees can come up and, you know, for honey frames and that, and then the brood chamber stays this size. But I am going to stay one hive with the lay-ins, just because I've already got it all built and all the frame sizes. So we'll have that with the lay-ins, and then my new hives are going to be this size. But yeah, so I got to go and throw these new nukes I got into their permanent hives. But thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.